Hello guys, welcome to my channel Chem Insider. So in today's video we are going to discuss about a further vapor pressure of solid in liquid solution. In the previous class we have discussed about the vapor pressure of liquid in liquid solution. That is, if you consider two volatile liquid solution, what happens is one of the liquid solution will be less volatile when compared to the other. So therefore we'll observe a change in vapor pressure or partial pressure of one liquid when compared to the other, which results in a explanation of total pressure exerted by this complete liquid solution with respect to one of its mole fraction of a component. Now, before going to the solid liquid vapor pressure, one point we have to observe over here is, if you are clear with the second video of this chapter, that is about the Henry's law, where we said that partial pressure is directly proportional to mole fraction of the given component. Partial pressure of a component will be directly proportional to the mole fraction of the component present in the solution. So which is later given as P is equal to KH into X, where KH is called the constant of Henry's law, that is Henry's constant. Now similarly in the Rolle's law, this was for Henry's law. Now for Rolle's law, in the previous video we discussed about partial pressure being proportional to mole fraction, right? Here also partial pressure is directly proportional to mole fraction of solvents and solutes, that is nothing but the liquids present in the given component, and which was proportionality constant was given as P naught of X. Okay, so if you observe here, equation 1 and equation 2, that is the partial pressure of equation, the partial pressure of a component taken in a solution is directly proportional to mole fraction of a given component if partial pressure of the pure component is equal to Henry's law constant. So we can say that Henry's law is nothing but Rolle's law when P naught is equal to KH, right? So P naught, that is the partial pressure of the pure substance, pure component, becomes equal to the Henry's law constant of the given component, then we can say that both Henry's law and Rolle's law are same. So therefore we can clearly say that we can use either of them for explaining gas in liquid solution or liquid in liquid solution. So that is what this Henry's law and Rolle's law are useful for. So if we relate these two, what we can say is Henry's law is nothing but Rolle's law if and only if the partial pressure of the pure liquid taken in case of Rolle's law is equal to the Henry's constant of the vapors formed by the given liquid. Okay, so this is all about the relation between Henry's and Rolle's law. So now we'll discuss about the vapor pressure of solid in liquid solutions. So vapor pressure of the second type of liquid solution, that is of solid in liquid. So when you consider solid in liquid kind of a solution, usually the solid will be a non-volatile component. Whenever you dissolve a solid solute in a solvent of liquid, the solute components will be non-volatile. That is, for example, if you consider sugar added to water, when you heat the complete component, what happens is water gets evaporated and sugar recrystallizes. Okay. If you are adding certain different component in water, again, like for example, a component of FeSO4, etc., water will get evaporated and leaving behind the salt components. So therefore, what we can say is, whenever you consider a solid in liquid solution, the solid component will always be a non-volatile component. So therefore, it won't have any amount of partial pressure exerting on a given liquid in a solution. So now, if you consider the given liquid taken in a closed container, if you observe a liquid taken in a closed container, let us say like this. So this is pure liquid, we haven't added any solute in it. And in the other container, we have taken the solution of the same liquid which you are considering here, and we have added some amount of non-volatile solute. So what happens here is, in this particular condition, when you add solute particle and we are not adding any solute particle in the other case, first we'll understand this about in this case. So if you heat this component of pure liquid, what happens is this liquid gets volatilized, evaporated, and the components present on the surface, will be just the liquid molecules, right? The components or the particles present on the surface of the liquid will be just the liquid molecules, and the vapor pressure will be exerted on these liquid molecules. Okay, if you observe for the solution, it has both solute and solvent molecules. So therefore, if you observe the partial pressure which has been liberated or which has been observed in case of liquid once it gets evaporated, what happens is, if you clearly see here, the amount of vapor pressure exerted is on the number of all the atoms, which are nothing but the liquid substances, liquid components, whereas here, some of the vapor pressure exerted by the vapor phase of the liquid is falling on the non-volatile solute particles. So therefore, we can say that the partial pressure of liquid in a solution is reduced when compared to the partial pressure of pure liquid. Partial pressure of liquid in a solution is less than that of the partial pressure of pure liquid. That is because once you add a non-volatile solute particle, those solute particles will be collected at the top of the surface. Okay, once they are collected at the top of the surface, here we can say that that is around 10 particles present in the surface. Here there is just 5 particles present at the surface. The number of particles present of the liquid here is 10, whereas here is just 5. So clearly we can say that the number of particles which accumulate on the surface is reduced. If the number of particles accumulated on the surface is reduced, so clearly the vapor pressure experienced by those particles is again reduced. Okay, so the vapor pressure experienced by the liquid here is completely less when compared to pure liquid. And further we can say that the partial pressure is reducing because of the particles of non-volatile solute placed over here. So with increasing solute, with adding a solute particle, we can clearly observe first condition is the partial pressure of liquid in a solution is less when compared to partial pressure of liquid in pure solvent. Second, the number of particles collected at the surface is reduced when compared to the number of particles collected at the surface of a pure liquid. Third point, the partial pressure experienced by the number of particles is less when compared to the partial pressure experienced by the particles of a pure liquid solvent. So therefore, we can clearly say that the partial pressure exerted in this component depends upon the mole fraction of solute added, the amount of solute added, but not on the nature of the solute. So that is, if you take water molecule in a container, if you consider water molecule in a container, if you add 1 kilogram of 1 mole of sugar, even if you add 1 mole of urea, the partial pressure of the liquid will be reduced in an equal extent. Okay, the partial pressure of liquid in case of if you are adding 1 mole of sugar or even if you are adding 1 mole of urea, the partial pressure will be reduced in the same extent. Okay, that is because the partial pressure of a solution depends upon the partial pressure of the mole fraction, depends upon the mole fraction of the solute present. So more the number of solute present, less will be its partial pressure. It doesn't depend upon what type of component you are adding. Okay, so it doesn't depend upon if you are adding sugar or if you are adding urea or if you are adding salt. It depends only on the amount of component added, amount of non-volatile solute added. Okay, so therefore it doesn't vary with respect to the nature of the solute, but it depends upon the amount of solute added to a given solution, added to a given solvent to form a solution. So now if you consider in this condition, so now what Raoult's law can say that is, instead of taking the components present here, Raoult's law altered in the equation, he says that for any solution, if you are considering for any solution, the partial pressure of the component, present in the solution is directly proportional to its mole fraction. Okay, the partial pressure for any component present in a solution is directly proportional to its mole fraction. In this case, the mole fraction of liquid is 1, whereas in this small fraction of liquid is 1 by 2. It has been reduced, right? So therefore, here the partial pressure of solvent, if you consider solvent as 1, solvent as component 1 or component A, and the solute as component B, then partial pressure of A, because B doesn't exhibit any partial pressure, so partial pressure of A is directly proportional to mole fraction of A, that is the mole fraction of solute. So PA is proportional to XA, and therefore PA will be equal to PA naught of XA, right? PA naught of XA. So this will be the equation for partial pressure of a given liquid taken in a solution of solid liquid. Okay, so the partial pressure of liquid in a solid liquid solution is given as PA is equal to PA naught of XA, where A is the nothing but the component of solvent. Okay, so now if you observe here on plotting a graph of PA versus XA, we'll obtain a straight line. If this is XA 0 and XA increasing in the x-axis and partial pressure PA is increasing along y-axis, then vapor pressure, instead of saying partial pressure, we can clearly say vapor pressure. So vapor pressure of liquid component of a given solid liquid solution increases with increase in the mole fraction of its component. Okay, so vapor pressure of the liquid or vapor pressure of a solid liquid solution increases with increase in mole fraction of solvent. Okay, so this is a straight line equation obtained for a curve of solid in liquid solutions. So this is about the vapor pressure of solid in liquid components. Okay, so what we are discussed here is, if you are considering a given particular component of solid liquid solution, the vapor pressure decreases because of the non-volatile solute added. So if you are adding a non-volatile solute, those non-volatile solute will not undergo evaporation and therefore they will not exert any amount of pressure on the surface of the liquid. But in the other sense, what we observe here is those particles which were not evaporated but will be collected on the surface of the liquid, which clearly reduces the amount of particles of solvent being collected on the top of the surface. Therefore, it reduces the number of particles present on the surface. It also reduces the pressure exerted by the particles, and it also swaps the number of particles being evaporated to the vapor phase also. Okay, so if you are adding a non-volatile solute as solvent, there will be three cases arising. One, it reduces the volatility of component because it is collected at the top of the surface. Second, because of its presence on the surface, it reduces the amount of particle present of the solvent on the surface. And in the third, we can say that it results in decrease in the vapor pressure experienced by the liquid surface. So this is all about the vapor pressure of liquid in solid substances and about the relation between Henry's and Rolle's law. I hope you have understood all these concepts which I explained today. In the next video, we'll discuss about ideal and non-ideal solution, and later we come across the four important properties of a given ideal or non-ideal solutions. Those are relative lowering of pressure, elevation in boiling point, depression in freezing point, and then osmotic pressure, reverse osmosis, etc. Okay, so I hope you understood this concept. If you have, well, good enough for me, please subscribe to my channel and share these videos among your friends in order to they get used of these videos. And thank you for watching.